Thank you. Thank you. of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. Please be seated. Join with me in prayer. Gracious, loving, kind God, we give you thanks to gather here in this place for your servant Luke and the difference he has made in so many lives. The love he shared with Luke, which all could see, the joy of their relationship, their many adventures together, traveling and making a home for their family, the love she gave her daughters. Grandchildren called her Lonnie, her son-in-law. She always put her family first. But even for that, we give you thanks for that witness. We also give you thanks that her reach went beyond her family. She fell, made a technician, a music director for children, occupational therapist. So many lives she touched. Even cancer could not. Thanks this morning that she loved you and was a witness to your grace. We remember how she loved to study the scriptures with others, loved to sing hymns and hear music that helped others experience your presence. And she sang as a member of our choir. And also she helped with our children as they learned how to sing and share their love of music. Give to each of us the hope that death is not the end of the journey, hers and hers. Not the end, but each of us the beginning. Trusting in the gracious love of God that we have seen in your Son. Help us to trust in knowing that life and death, we belong not to ourselves. We belong to God. We ask this. Thank you. Why do you say, O Jacob, servant of Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known, have you not heard, the Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth, who does not fade to the Lord, and to the church. He gives power to feign and strengthen the powerless, even youthful, feign to be weary, and youth will fall exalted, exhausted of those who wait for the Lord. Shall renew their strength, they shall not have wings like eagles, they shall run and not be weary, they shall walk and not sleep. And then Psalm 22. Where is my step with that? He makes me lie down in green pastures. He makes me sit still. He restores my soul. He leads me in right places for his name's sake, even though I walk through the darkest valley. I fear no evil. Anoint my head with oil, my covering. For the goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. This morning, Ellie is going to sing a song that her grandmother loved and loved having her sing to me. Ellie, thank you.
I keep hearing voices in my mind that say we're not enough. Every single lie that tells me I'll never measure up.
Thank you.
that this man must marry. First, he must die. His poor princess, the queen, she was going to die, and to whom? His king, the prince himself, and those to show that she's the one true mother. Because the other one, when he set out the fire, he said, I don't know where he's going. But the wife had a fight, what's going on? You know, he has been refining again, he's a jerk, he's completely wrong. I'm sick of it, when I come to my state with you for a little bit, he said, no, he must suffer with his mistakes. We are at sacred state here. He let us suffer for my son, and we're going to why is your point of view? Is the truth so long? I can hear it before it's going to be that word last time, too. We've got a staff meeting like this that was. It was just over 4 years ago. 4 years long. Like, this is a bad spot. You know, so the fact is, I love it very much. basically met. Let's take off 10% for COVID vacations and homeless. We talked about 40 for an M36 migration, times 50 times two visits for each of the got to get back from quite practice service. That's 3,744 visits. Service, and then they come back and see the need for the second service. Oftentimes they went to that, so that's 3 hours. You went there, that's 5,616 hours in this campus. If you consider some of the things, this is your course at school, that's all it's at. 12,600 hours, which is maybe 6,000 hours. 6,000 hours is the same thing as the full-time work. That is a tremendous amount of time that you get to this church. Also, this method on music. If there were 6 songs per service, that's 36. Oh yeah, 36 years times 50 minutes times 6 songs per service. We would say somewhere in the ballpark of 11,250 seconds. If you make up 10 songs per service, which is actually probably not realistic, it comes out to 14,976 songs. And I'm sure it's actually probably higher than that. So Lou really was in choir. She led the Christian soprano in her life she held fast and she continued to pray. We never did. We took letters from a different church from that so special. I think it was that. Here, we really love this church. She would have loved knowing she had been here. She would have been more actually loved this church. So let's go on more aspects of this book. We got to Lou's early life, including Jesus. Some of y'all don't know this. Lou was not an infant. In fact, she was a baby. She did pretty good for thinking, but there were a few telltale signs. The room was not fit to stay. You didn't really expect that. You really expected it. Things weren't huge. They were huge. She didn't use a washing machine. She used a washing machine. She didn't drink root beer. She drank wheat beer. And we kind of got in trouble sometimes. We came out of here and started to drink beer. Maybe the one that I read is if you catch us in it. It was kind of funny because I never say this word to it would be funny when you break up the same phrases that she wanted to have this whole piece said, like, you know, I hope that huge root beer I drink on washroom dishes doesn't ruin my appetite. So, she never said things like that, but I just so deliciously wanted her to. So, anyway, just check through some of the other things. That's the colorized blue baby photo. Look how cute that is, the color. And now look at that one. That one's horrific. And it's not her, it's the way they did the colorization. It looks like it's California. Okay. The next one, here's Lou. They're like, oh no, she's what, 86 or 7. The next one, she already has like the little face. Sweet God, it's like a bug. Next one, the booty. Next one, just to get it, I'm getting a photo. Next one, this is Lou, and I'm holding her red with 1952 Santa. Most things in your 50s, like how old person you work on this year. They kind of look at what's going on. Next one, there's this really wide hand photo. This one, like a 40 year old, but maybe it's all close to that. Maybe it's not as you can see. Okay. So, it's a large one. Okay, and then this next one here. I'll just have said, right here, Jeff. You know, if you have one, so. Lou is a looker. You know, I probably shouldn't say that. I just don't know, but that is true. Okay. So let's move on to the college and career. I have a lot of slides. In 1966, I actually got a degree in biology. 1966, a degree in biology. I was put in for special reasons at Greek church. And I'm coming at a time that I enjoy. Women have said, well, it was just very well accepted, but this is 1966. I started from 66. I mean, 7.4. Thank you. we mentioned Favorite Penton song. So picture it. It's a great time. the city, there comes the power of the Lord. Being a beautiful as the day was, comes to check out. And his idea of help is to put his life in action and summon his daughters to to come witness the spectacle that was Luke. So let's go to the next slide. I did a clear feed out to him. This is Luke, whose posterior has gone through and the wicker part of the chair, and she was stuck like that and screaming bloody murder. And Ray thought the best thing to do for himself and Luke was to get his children, and they were just going, I think there was an attempt to get a camera, but this was she's got this weird 47 foot, and there's every kind of thing going. And I have like a personal potential point, especially fixed. So I just need to talk to the others to cut out because, I'm getting this. Next one. We're ready again. Next one. That's it. Period. I can see I'm already on. Next one. Yeah, just tell me that it's good. Really? Next one. Spices. I think because the condition of the world is good, one of them was good. And he's like, when he was in his 40s, I was like, batteries or something, he's like, one every day. So like, they find it in the morning. But just those his memories, his trip was always a great time. Every year, going to the street, seems to be a blessing in my time. And he came to the street, it was a great time. I'm in his school, and I took him. That's the 4th of July. He was like, all these deep rivers. To show this because of Mary's cultural appropriation. I said, I would take the heat for it. She's dressed as like a Milwaukee. But then there was this process. Next one. This one. Because she's kind of working on this little chance. Next one. So, have a great time. Next one. Thanksgiving, I'm looking to serve a special one for food. And that was always a fun time, which gets to my life and it's such a tough collection. This is my last grand campus, which is incredible to Stefan, the guest of the Civil Rights Center. I'm the type of people, you know, you're married to a family. This, but it's kind of tricky. Number 3 is a community kid with a 7. I hope you're not joking. Number 4 is in Janice's sweet tea. That is addictive. And then the 5th one is Lou's recipe, which is a thing you can do quite as often. Again, why is it ever such a simple? So let's advance that process. Christmas lights to finish me first. But at the same time, Christmas, of course, let's go through the movies. They make Christmas a good deal. My presents, very, very generous. Thank you. For the next one, the gingerbread houses at the Valley's behind the Carter's defense for many, many years. And every year, she was under the committee as one of the perfect kids that went into the series. Next week, just Christmas morning, they always came over March 9th, open presents. Next one, just some random Christmas stuff. Next one, I'm pretty sure who made those outfits. Is that correct? Oh, my bad. She bought them. But they were definitely. Christmas was always a good time. And again, if it wasn't about the presents, I think she just thought about it. I really do. Interestingly, the epistle I wrote the first time I was in the same with my wife and my sister was at the summit. I remember that small door was in at the summit where they used to have concerts. And you know that first time I went to it, we were talking many years ago, turned out that we all went to that same concert. So I think that's what I'm talking about. Didn't know each other before. I wish you could see her facial expression better. This is like, it's not really just punched you up without like much warning. And she is like freaked out. But she was a trooper, man. She really did tell him. I think she really did. But it was like, next one. Just random. First year of marriage, came out of the divorce, especially at graduate school, which is a big center of esteem. And for whatever reason, we were doing some business in East Texas and decided to stay with the divorce and I went to the center of the board, left pretty early in the morning, to get up for school, grab a backpack, come out the door. The nature of this apartment is that the front door is by the desk. Not in station clothing, not a towel, not a doily, nothing. Just plain. It did like her. Doesn't matter. Not as if she was the way she was born. I was next to my screen. I was standing there. And like, I thought it was like, here in the heads, I said, I didn't dare look down, but you know, it seemed like an eternity, but it's only like half a second. And I was like, the only thing I could think of doing is just turning and just keep going. So I got in the car and I just, you know, started driving to school and I called him. I was like, oh my God, I just like, I don't know what to do. I was like, I wasn't trying. She just had the door right open. She was saying, I don't know if she forgot I was still there. What? I was like, I don't, like, do I go back in and say, I'm sorry? Do I call her? Is there a car for this? So Kim was like, she's like, I don't know. Maybe she didn't see this in a week or like that. So she knows, like, so I saw her. And she's like, well, let's just let it slide. Let's see if she rents it. In what, 24 years? So the one time I can do. I know if she knows. But I know if she knows. So, enough of that. There's no slides for this one either. There was no slides for that story. You're welcome. There's no slides for this one either. My greatest kisses for you today, except for the color. Was 4 years ago. Worse than I ever have to say. And when Ray had the advantage, he was a decent driver, he was a good driver. Blue. The great thing is she was good at driving for some point. A woman drove to 2 feet. And if you had not ridden with her, the test track in Disney was the best part of this piece of stuff. Yeah, nice of her. That is horrible. One time she drove from her up on a boat. And it was like a kind of Walmart there. She rode up on a boat in a fourth place. I was like, how do you even do this? The physics don't even make sense. And she couldn't explain it either. It just happened. You know, but the cool thing is, like, she heard a lot of cars, like, her insurance was insane expensive. But she never had any paper. So, you know, I guess she didn't drive any faster than her car changing was fine. There was one time, for those of you who know, I'm going to saw this. you're going to at least kind of hard right here. It's 90 degrees under the It's like almost you have to stop. Like, there's no stop there. I just so happen to be driving in front of a little group of people or something together. And just coming in front of them. I make the turn. It is rare. It is cold. It's freezing. These roads are not contributing to the first 2 foot getting this done. And if she makes that turn, she continues. The funny thing was, what if nobody's heard her seen anything? She just started. But she was like Sam Eagle of the Muppets. Like, she didn't think she could move around. She just moved up. She was like, the whole time. And, fortunately, there were no cars around her. She didn't question anything. And so, I rolled my window down and just came back to the beach. Rolled the window down. She was fine. It was like the weirdest thing. I wish I had done the video. So let's cover a few more memories. This is where you're going. Why do I take pictures like that? I'm a jerk. I know. I like to take pictures of people in pizza food too. Like, it's kind of odd. This is one Maddie took. I thought she was like pretty honest. Get more street, that's like a and for some reason she doesn't like people on the picture. And they just kind of unofficially enjoy having breakfast and breakfast. And to be true, I like to be fair. It's kind of the one that helps out for some special day. We just like to spend time with any excuse you have to keep that's not going to pursue it. Find a way to get hold of next one. Kind of family, putting together puzzles, next one. Senior reports of age. This next one's a good one. And the big, this is Lou dressed up like a Vanderpump. And I always get the sequence to tell her show. And she said, I'm waiting to be lovely, which I think was like, my fair lady is really looking at me. And if anybody's not with her, she has like that. And she really. Lou likes to at her piano when he has kids. There's a one time, you know, back in 2016, we got a special set of five duets. So 99 duets, 199. And they thought it would be a great idea to sing a duet together. Okay. What are they going to do? These classic country songs from then came in clean. Well, except when I get to the line, we ran it together, making love with each other. But as I came to the past, it's like 15 years later, I'm still just this is their number 5. This is a unique experience for me. This is the very first time in my life where I've met a woman in power. And we're drooling over the same man in the capital game. That's a special feeling. Next one. This is blue. It's kind of hard to see. Her face, because she's so small. But she looks kind of best. I'm pretty sure this picture was taken in Colorado. Draw the conclusions that you want. And that is this current this is blue, my divorce pay, I don't know when this was, but it was very interesting. This is Christmas Eve, and actually, we have friends and family for it. We all met together, and we see you when you're ready to have this dinner. It was a real blessing. It was a very, very impressive moment. I'm not perfectly set. There are a few times where she had kind of extra 6 weeks. At one point, Zoe sat down and she said, "What's your name, Shorty?" And there was another time where Lou was opening her gifts, but she was just like, "Yeah, let's go see what it is." And she was reading the passage of Lou. And I'm not going to share the word, but Lou is a big powerful word. And it's probably almost certainly not printed on it for this little package. But she said it anyway. And a room full of 4 teenage girls and 3 teenagers with immature adults just started giving her heads up. And she starts to look like, "You've got dirty minds." Like, "Well, you were the one that said it." But, whatever. And then the next one is that same day that's been again, you see Lou smiling. I just love that half of the movie. It was a real blessing. She was very present. She knew where she was. She knew what she was there. She knew what she was doing. She knew what she was doing. We had a lot of great moments. And so, this is one with one of the eight pets. That's Tink. And if you didn't know, Tink works almost exactly like
memories and from this life that has been shared with us, we turn to Scripture to hear words of hope, to hear words of assurance. And so we first turn to the beginning of the Gospel of John. We hear John's hymn, appropriate for your mom, appropriate for Linda, who would hear him. His hymn of Christ, the Word made flesh. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light, the true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God. Who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. We have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. And then, in Paul's letter to the Romans in the 8th chapter, Paul reminds us of the love of God that we find in Christ Jesus. Paul writes, "What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own Son, but gave him up for all of us, will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Finally, in Paul's letter to the Philippians, he gives and prays in thanksgiving to the church. He says, I thank my God every time I remember him, constantly praying with joy in every one of my prayers for all of you because of your sharing in the gospel from the first day until then. I am confident. The one who began a good work among you will bring it to completion by the day of Jesus Christ. Friends, we gather this morning in memory of Llewellyn May Penton. We gather with hearts that are full. They are full because we are saddened by her death. But our hearts are also full because we can celebrate her life. Remember her fondly. Remember the life that she lived so well and the love that she shared with so many. But we gather also with hearts that are full because they are full of the hope that we find and we
bear witness today, the hope that we have in Christ Jesus. We rest and we trust in this hope. We know that while death is past for Lou, it does not have the final word. We remember that. Scripture tells us, and we believe, that God has given us the gift of hope. And it is fitting that in these early days of a new year, as we continue to remember the light of Christ, which has come into the world, that we have heard a hymn of creation we call the Lord of Time. And while we know that Christ is Word and light and life, who was with God and who was God at the very beginning, we also know that this Word, this light that is Christ, became flesh and dwelt among us. And in Him we have come to know God more fully. And we also know in Him that God knows us more fully. We know that God has entered into our lives, into our hopes, into our dreams, and yes, even into our sorrow. Later in John's Gospel, we find that this living in flesh Word was at a tomb, the tomb of his friend Lazarus. And there, this living Word was moved by grief. Grief that he shared with Mary and with Martha and those who were gathered mourning for Lazarus. And with them, he wept. And before he called his friend Lazarus out of the tomb, he also spoke words of assurance and hope to Lazarus' sister, Martha. Words we can find hope in even today. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life." We hear Christ's words of hope, and we remember the assurances that our faith gives witness to. The hope that God is not finished with us, not even when we die. Paul's words to the Romans remind us of this, that nothing in life, and certainly not death, can separate us from the presence and love of God we know in Christ. God has given us the hope that death is not an end, but is a new beginning. This is the hope that we cling to as we gather today, and as we grieve the loss of one who loves so dearly. But God's gifts do not end there. The gift of hope, God has given us the gift of memory. And we remember today that all life is a gift from God. We remember that especially as we remember Him. And we, like Paul for the Philippians, can truly give thanks to God every time we think of Him, giving thanks for the gift of her life, because Lou was indeed a gift. She has left us with some gifts from her life that we can always treasure. Jason has shared many of those gifts. We thank God for the gift of Lou and for the many ways that Lou gifted herself to others selflessly. Lou's generosity found many forms. Grateful for all that she had, even in the midst of storms, even in the lean times, give thanks for the ways that this gratitude for her life influenced her generosity and made itself known in so many ways, including her dedication to her community and to her church. She loved her church family deeply. She loved her Bible study and the choir and so many more aspects of this Christian family. She loved her community as well, PEO and the Woodlands Corral. She loved her neighborhood and her Bunko group. She loved her friends. She was a talented and generous hostess, as I'm sure many of you are aware. She loved to gather with friends and family alike, and she made sure that all those around her felt welcome and loved and as they belong. She ensured that folks, including some of her pastors, including me, had a place to be and people to be with on the holidays and other times of celebration, because she wanted to make sure that no one was alone for those times. such as she loved a party, a gathering, a celebration with friends and family, we can give thanks that this Christmas was a good one. Lou was a helper. She loved children and animals, and one only ever hoped to listen to the way she spoke of her children, her family, especially her grandchildren. She was deeply committed to the people that she loved, even putting her dreams on the back burner so that she could put her family first. We give thanks for the gift of Lou's generosity. We also give thanks for the gift of Lou and for her sharp mind and her quick wit. As Jason shared, she put her intelligence to work in her undergraduate studies and in her work in the biomedical field and then as a teacher. And then she put that intelligence and bravery into work yet again when she returned to school as an adult, pursuing a career again as an occupational therapist where she continued to be a helper and a caregiver to children. She had a knack for helping people understand complex ideas, words, and concepts. Remember, she shared that she could always define a difficult word or idea in a way that even a young child could understand that. I think we all wish that we had that talent. Kim said that she always thought that she was the smartest person in the world. Lou's bright personality and her wit made her a delightful conversationalist. Which even found its ways into the grandparent names that she and Ray chose for themselves, Lolly and Pop, as the girls shared, because they were such suckers for their grands. And anyone who knew Lou and knew Ray knew this to be really true. We give thanks for the gift of. And as we give thanks for Lou's mind, we also give thanks for her tenacity and for her sense of adventure. She and Ray loved to travel, and their adventurousness and Ray's work took them to many beautiful and inspiring places, places Lou never imagined she would ever see. And Lou's sense of adventure continues even as her memory began to fade. She would travel with the one, the people she was with. Kind and funny and sweet, Lou was also spiciness sometimes made itself known as a temper, you would rarely see it. She used it judiciously. Lou's spiciness and her tenacity also took her to school and encouraged her into a new career later in life. This tenacity helped sustain her through a cancer diagnosis and through treatment. And she continued to work through a good part of that treatment. And yet, at least some of this tenacity and her perseverance was grounded in the relationships that she had with friends, with family, and with her church community, which sustained her through these seasons of struggle, seasons such as her cancer. She felt that her communities, and especially this church, were like the eagle's wings of Isaiah's passage we read this morning, which lifted her up and supported her people. And while Lou's tenacity helped her to do things and to weather the storms of her life, she would want everyone to know how good her life was, how blessed she felt, and how we should all cherish the blessings we have. We give thanks to God for that gift. We give thanks to God for Lou's gift for music. She loved to make music. It was her life. And our service this morning bears witness to that. It's filled with hymns and songs and choirs and ensembles of pieces and people that she loved dearly. She loved making music with people. She loved singing in the choir and with the Woodlands Chorale. And I know how much she loved teaching music to young people, helping lead music with our children's choirs and at Vacation Bible School throughout the years. We give thanks to God for the gift of song that Lou always carried in her heart. We give thanks to God for the gift of Lou and for the love that he shared for so, with so many. All of you gathered here this day to bear testimony to them. But especially we give thanks to God for the life, the love that he shared with Lou for 51 years, and for the family that they brought together, for the adventures they went on with each other. Family, like her church, were so very important to Lou. Her family, those she loved deeply, those she loved the most, and what she was most important to. She would light up any time I talked to her as her kids, her grandkids, and then when Aria came along, her family as well. They were her true delight. She loved her furry family. Her kitties, Mama and Shadow, we bonded over those kitties. I know that they brought her joy and comfort as she had that she got to see them, even if they put an action on them one last time. I know these last several years after Ray's death have been hard on them. So we give thanks that she has been reunited with them today. Just to say one thing. She would want you to know how much of a gift you were to her, how important you were. We give thanks for the love that Lou shared with all of you and with Ray, for the family of friends that she built around her, because this is the most tangible way she could give herself to us. Lou was a truly remarkable, genuine woman, and we give great thanks for the gift of her and of her life. She touched so many lives. It was a gift. And so today, as we give thanks for her life, as we remember her, as we celebrate her, we also give thanks for the faith which guided and supported and grounded her, which encouraged and inspired her. We give thanks for her faith that sustained her throughout her life, a faith that she lived out so visibly. There's so much more that has been said and that could be said about this good, kind, loving, generous, dedicated, remarkable woman. Today, we give thanks to God for the countless named and unnamed and unnameable ways God has gifted us with Lou, and Lou has gifted us with herself. Today's not an easy day. There have been tears. There will be more. But today, we also celebrate, and we give thanks to God for one that we love so much. It's okay to pray. These tears that we shed are a reminder of how much we love Lou and how much we want to love Lou. I know these last months have been a challenge to watch someone so bright, and so witty, and so excited about life. Give thanks that this place to be a woman did not linger, and that she has found healing and wholeness, which in some ways itself was a gift. So today, we can remember Lou and we can celebrate with her that her suffering and death are not the end of her story, nor will they one day be an end of our story. Our faith reminds us that Jesus is light and light. And even when we die, we live in Him. This is something that we can truly be sure of, that we can cling to. Christ's work did not end on a cross or with an empty tomb. Even now, Christ is at work praying for us and sharing His love. love, God's love, for that is stronger than anything that we can imagine that we're creating. We cling to that hope, a hope of a love that will not let us go, a hope that can sustain us as we face a loss such as this, a loss of someone we love so dearly, a love of someone who loved us. This is the hope that we have that we say goodbye today. Hope that in life and in death, and in life beyond death, nothing, not cancer, not illness, not pain or memory can separate us from the hope we need to love us. Let's pray. Oh God of grace, you have given us new and living hope in Jesus Christ. You have made us in your image, and you hold us in your care. And we thank you that by dying, Christ has destroyed the pain of death. That by rising from the grave, he has opened the way to the abundant life. Help us to know that because Christ lives, we shall live also. That neither death, nor life, nor things present, nor things to come shall be able to separate us from your love. We praise you this day for all your servants who, having lived this life of faith, now live eternally with you. And today we are grateful for you. Especially we thank you for your servant, whose baptism is now complete. We praise you for all in her that helped her love you and serve you faithfully. We thank you for the gift of life and for everything in her that is good. For the grace you give for us. You told us that you are the resurrection and the life, and you give us hope in that. You promised to comfort those who mourn, and so we pray that you would comfort us now, all of us who grieve for you. You raised the dead to life, and so now we can trust you into your eternal care. Holy One, we give you thanks that for the death is past, for pain has ended, and he has entered the joy which you have prepared to Jesus Christ. Give rest, O Christ, to your soul, with all of your saints, for there is neither pain nor sorrow nor sighing, but life everlasting. And hear us now as we pray in the manner Christ taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Now our grandchildren will share. For it is truly well.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrow I see billows roll, thank you.
as we leave this place, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord be kind and gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor.